Nina, it's Daisy. Come on over. I've got something for all the girls in Savannah, for all the girls in America, for all the girls in the world. And we are going to start it tonight. I made that phone call to my cousin, Nina Anderson Pape, on March 12th of 1912. And it was on that night that the Girl Scouts of America was born. Welcome. My name is Juliet Gordon Lowe, and I am the founder of the Girl Scouts of America. Now, all you adults out there, you might call me Mrs. Lowe, but for the children, and I hope maybe some of my Girl Scouts, you may all call me Miss Daisy. Miss Daisy is what all my girls call me. Now, we're going to be talking tonight a lot about being a Girl Scout, and you'll hear about my own story too, but I'm wondering, I'm sure and hoping that there are many out there who are Girl Scouts tonight. Maybe you were a Girl Scout when you were a little girl, and maybe you're one now, or maybe you hope to be, but tonight, I am making everyone an honorary Girl Scout. And since you're going to be honorary Girl Scouts, we're going to begin with the Girl Scout salute. I'm going to teach it to you. Now, you can just stand right where you are. And girls out there who are Girl Scouts, you should be doing this with me. And you're going to put your three fingers up to make a Girl Scout salute. And those three fingers stand for the three parts of the Girl Scout promise: duty, service, obedience. And then if you want to do a Girl Scout handshake, you're going to extend your left hand to the person you want to shake hands with. Why your left hand? Because your left hand leads to your heart. Now, once you have those fingers up, of course, and you are doing your salute, then you can also do your Girl Scout promise. I want you to listen very carefully as I give you the promise as it was first written. On my honor, I will try to do my duty to God and to my country, to help other people at all times to obey the laws of the Scouts. Perhaps your Girl Scout promise sounds a little different. Well, that's just fine. No matter how it might have been changed, remember, whenever you recite your promise, recite it with pride.